Well, what is your risk of developing breast cancer over the next 5 years? What if we had the answers about your risk up to the age of 90? Dr. Summer Chaudhry is the medical director of the Breast Healthcare Center at Missouri Baptist Medical Center. She's with us this morning with more on a tool that can help. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
Yeah, first of all, you said it's not really a tool per se. What exactly are we talking about?
So it's a breast cancer risk assessment. Mm-hmm. Models. There are multiple different models that exist. They function on different factors such as your family history of breast cancer, your personal health history. They may include your breast density and some other health information that you provide. And they calculate a risk of breast cancer that a woman may have. For example, what is your 10, you know, lifetime risk of developing breast cancer? And if it is, generally speaking, the accepted number or cutoff is 20% or greater is considered high risk. So we encourage women to have that risk assessment done from their doctor or the local breast center. Some of them have risk assessment programs, like at Missouri Baptist, we have a dedicated risk assessment program. And they calculate a score for you. These aren't exact percentages. Mm-hmm. These are estimates that kind of give you an idea that you may be high risk or, you know, you may be average risk. That will determine when to initiate screening mammography. Mm-hmm. For women who are high risk, we actually initiate screening mammography at age 30 instead of the usual 40 years and above. Okay. And also it can include some other screening modalities that can help in detecting breast cancer.
And these are used in conjunction with a mammogram. This is not to replace the mammogram. It's like you said, maybe to speed up your time of getting in to get a mammogram done.
Well, absolutely. So, you know, by far and large, I would say your annual mammogram is the most important exam. Mm-hmm. The risk assessment for, determines if you're high risk. And then if you are high risk, we recommend some adjunct screening modalities, which can include whole breast screening with ultrasound or what is the now more encouraged modality, it's breast MRI. So women with high risk are definitely encouraged to do, annual adjunct screening with breast MRI. It is not a replacement for your mammograms, but it can supplement it.
Yeah, I did the test yesterday, one of them, and it, honestly, it took me maybe a minute. It's very quick to do it. Mine were right at average.
Yeah.
If you are in that high risk, what's the first thing you should do?
So I would say I would talk to your doctor, assuming that your doctor referred you to a program, the person who's coordinating the program may also have some recommendations. But first and foremost, you should have your annual mammogram if you're 30 years and above. After that, then there's a consideration, should you do breast MRI? Or a whole breast ultrasound. Mm-hmm. Generally speaking, as I said, now the more generally accepted recommendation is to do that annual MRI. And you can do it not at the, necessarily at the same time as your annual screening mammogram, but you can do it maybe 6 months apart. So we're trying to decrease that interval for screening. So if something develops in between your two mammograms, it may be caught. Also, breast MRI helps with dense breasts. If you have very dense breasts, it can see through the tissue pretty well as well.
All right, Dr. Summer Chaudhry, thank you so much for being with us this morning. Yes, we appreciate it. We're going to take a break. We'll be back.